She's up there with the big names, Carla Thomas, a lot of the old-time soul and R&B singers, and they think she's fantastic. So we are thrilled that she lives nearby in Sebastopol and is able to come to us for our next choir benefit. Please come out and join us. It's only $10 to come. We will have a silent auction, a raffle. We'll have beer and wine. We will have some treats provided by the hall that you need to bring extra money for. It is a fundraiser for the Big Valley Hall as well as for Hope City, because you may notice we need to renovate. There's a few things we could work on. We have some flooring. We need to work a little bit on the ceiling. We need to get the air conditioning. We're working with Pop. Pop, please stand up. We need to acknowledge Pop has worked really hard with us, otherwise known as Dennis Booth. Dennis has been really helping us pull this together. He also has something called the Music Club. And he has a show on KPSV on Thursdays. It's live from 7 to 9. It's a blues and rock show called Treasures, Lost Treasures. And it also airs again, for those of you who aren't on the radio on Thursdays, that's on Fridays from 3 to 5, which is when I catch it when I'm driving around. So please listen in to Pop. He plays some really good music. He does interviews with a lot of our folks who come and play for our benefits. I also want to acknowledge somebody who's in the audience who just did a wonderful benefit for Tricia Danielli. Please give it up for Randy McGowan from the Queen Chad. Randy! Stand up for Randy! Randy also did our Halloween benefit. He also did our Halloween benefit last year over at North Shore Community Center with the Queen Chads. He donates his time to so many good causes. He's actually just here to enjoy the music. We're going to have more. We're going to come back, but I want to introduce you to Roberta. Roberta is the chair of the Big Valley Hall. She's going to tell you about the hall. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, Tina. And let's thank Tina for arranging this. And also special thanks to Lorna and Joan for amazing goodies. And Pam came back from her surgery and made brownies. Yay, Pam. And John and Rose provided the amazing melon, and they're slaving away and they're cutting up fruit for you guys. So, and John Sayer at the membership table. So, can everybody hear me? Okay. So, like Tina was saying, for a long time, our hall has been a resource for the community, and we've been providing cultural events, entertainment, education, and a venue for nonprofit events, rentals for private events, and a meeting place for members of the community. And just to give an idea of the kinds of things that have been deferred, the floor, during the winter, when it just would not stop raining, the water table just came up. We have a lot of floor damage, actually needs to be replaced, and the water began to just come up the hall, the walls. So really what I want to say is, if we want to be able to continue to have this hall as a resource for the community, we need to take care of it. And it won't just be here by itself. Nobody else is doing it. We need everyone in the community who appreciates this resource to step in and help us out. We're not going to dump a whole bunch of volunteering on anyone who joins, though. I'll promise you that. But we do have several teams that could use a hand once a month, a few times a year, or whatever fits into your life. So the question is, why have a lodge at all? About 100 years ago in this country, lodges provided help to members since there was not much of an official social safety net. And they helped families that had suffered a loss, and they made sure that children could be educated. We have somewhat different difficulties in this community at this point, but we still want to create a tight-knit community. We still want to be close to our neighbors. So Big Valley Hall members have made a vow to help each other thrive and survive in good times and to stand by each other in hard times. We contribute to the surrounding community and we enjoy each other's friendship. In addition to being more connected to each other, we also want to be more connected to nature. So a really big project for our members is to work on practical ways to respect the natural world. And this means learning about ways to achieve a more personal and less abstract relationship with the natural, with nature in Big Valley. And that can include gardening, landscaping, gathering food, or gardening, or whatever it takes to care for the system. And we also have members working on the arts, poetry, music, healing arts, and various other forms of spirituality and the arts and sciences. Big Valley Hall is voluntarily affiliated with the California Guild in Sacramento. And this is a fraternal community service organization with over 80 chapters all across California, mostly in Northern California, but really all the way from Imperial Valley all the way up to Humboldt. Each chapter decides how to best serve its community, so we're really autonomous, and members participate at the level that works for them. So the Guild itself advocates for healthy communities, family farms, and local economies. And they've been involved in a variety of charitable causes. One of them that might interest people here is called Noah's Wish, and that's a program that's devoted to assisting pets and their owners during natural disasters. So that's something that strikes near and dear to a lot of people in Lake County. The Guild lobbyists in Sacramento have also successfully supported legislation to assist military veterans in starting careers in farming, and they were also successful in removing what amounted to a ban on seed libraries. And this was legislation that prevented farmers and gardeners from sharing seed with others in the region where they live, and we got that ban eliminated. So that's called seed freedom. And that was the California Guild that did that. So for many years, they've been working on getting industrial hemp reintroduced as a renewable resource. So California Guild members, including Big Valley Hall, welcome new members from all walks of life, and we want to reflect the diversity and contributions of the whole community. And the organization that was here before was not very diverse, and we would really like to change that. We would like to see a lot more people of whatever nationality or whatever, participating. Town people, farm people, whatever. So we're also nonpartisan and non-denominational. So I just want to thank you all for being here. Thank you very much for being here, and I hope you all join.
Well, I'm Joan Taylor. I'm the treasurer here at Big Valley Hall. Yeah, I know I am. The money. which there's not a lot of. But anyway, I want to tell you about our scholarship program. We help graduating seniors at Kelseyville High School who are going into the field of agriculture. We have 3 scholarships. We give them every year. And 2 of them are in honor of Virginia Sills and Ruby Glebe. Ruby was our county historian at one time. So really honored ladies. We have a craft fair the first Saturday in December, and that helps pay for those scholarships. So if anybody's interested in being a vendor at our craft fair, you come see me and I'll give you a form and we'll sign you up. Do you know that our building can be rented? We can rent it for parties and weddings and baptisms and dances and dinners and all kinds of good stuff. So if you want, I can give you Dennis's number. He's our rental chairman. He'd be glad to sign you up. It's a nice building. At the end of this month or the beginning of next month, we will have a brand new air conditioner installed also. Yeah. So we're moving along here, you know. Anyway, we also have a delightful breakfast on the first Sunday of every month. Now, we have homemade egg frittatas for scrambled eggs, bacon and sausage, homemade pancakes, French toast with homemade bread and homemade syrup. We have a fruit salad and juice and coffee, and all of that for $8. Now you know, you can't get that anywhere for $8. That's a good deal. So don't forget, the first Sunday of every month. It's served buffet style from 8 until noon. And you know, in 45 minutes, we can serve a whole room full of people. So there's no wait. So come and join us, first Sunday of every month. Okay? We want you to come down and start your Sunday morning with a ray of down-home sunshine. I was asked to read this also, our 5th choir fundraiser, which is called Halloween Spirits, will be held right here at Valley Hall on Saturday, October 21st. There's going to be flyers out, there'll be advertising and everything. There's a $10 cover charge, which includes rock, rhythm and blues, and soul music by the Laura Lee Christensen Band from Sonoma County. There will be a no-host bar, juice, treats, a raffle, a silent auction, and dance and costume contest with prizes. So don't forget, this proceeds will benefit our Big Valley Hall renovations and also help Hope City for the fire rebuilding efforts. If you want further details, Hope City is a disaster relief agency from Elkhart, Indiana, that has been rebuilding homes lost in the 2015 and 16 fires in Lake County for those with no insurance or insufficient insurance. Now, when it comes to our Christmas craft fair, this first Saturday in December, I'm the chairman. If you want to be a vendor, you can contact me. I have flyers. I have vendor forms and everything available. The money from this craft fair that the hall makes all goes to our scholarships. So if you want to come the first Saturday in December, we would be delighted to have you here. I hope you enjoy today, and thank you so much for being here today with us.
Thank you, Joan. I just want to bring your attention to these flyers. All the information you need to know, you can bring home with you. But we also hope that you'll sign up for membership. We need members to help us. There's lots of fun things to do here, and we're going to hear more about them a little bit later on. But meanwhile, I want to bring your attention to our wonderful duo from Cobb, Teardrop Trailer. This is John and Leah Jennings. Thank you.
First time. beach, hear the water speak.
Thank you.
sadness and despair.
Your stillness and the dust of dreams now. Just like my daddy used to be before. turn down. Still can remember that rumbling sound.
No problem, did I see? And no, I
death of me. And oh, how terrible was the death of me.
Thank you once again to Leah and John Jennings. They give a lot to our community. They played a lot of community events, not just at the Cobb, but down in Middletown and all around the lake. I'm going to come around after this asking for tips for them, because we have limited amounts of money that we can pay to our musicians, but we are thrilled that they're here. So here's my $5 to start, and I'm hoping people will come up and help us pay the musicians for their time and effort for coming here. I just want to introduce you to our next speaker. We have a short information break. Lorna Sue Sides is going to come on up. She runs the kitchen. She is instrumental to our Sunday breakfasts. She is instrumental to all of our snacks. Yay, John! If you would like to become a member, this is John Sayer. He's at the front desk. He can tell you how to become a member. We desperately need people, because as we all get older, our energies are limited, but you could come and you could just sit at a table during an event, and that would be wonderful. Maybe you should pass it around.
You can pass it. You got the job.
Yay, okay, John has the job. These are the easy little things that members can do. We have meetings once a month, the first Wednesday from 6 to 8. If you would like to come to a meeting, everybody is welcome. And if you come, there's a potluck, and they have lots and lots of food. And it's really good at hot food. They have desserts. They have a lot of food. So you need to come and eat the food and help us out and give us your input and let us know what you'd like to see here at the hall, because this is a community resource. So I'm going to introduce you to Lorna. Once again, thank you to Teardrop Trailer. I've known them for a couple of years, back to the days of Jellystone Park when I filmed them up at Cobstock. And that's how I got to know them, and I'm thrilled that they were able to come down and join us here. Thank you.
My name is Lorna Sides, and I live in Kelseyville. I'm a member, and I hold the office of Scribe here at Big Valley Hall. My history with the hall began several years ago. I was working full-time. I had a house and a home and friends and a yard and a cat, but I really felt like I needed something else going in my life. So I thought about it and decided I would join some kind of an active community. I came down to the hall, and as I learned more about the hall, I was really impressed with the members and their organization. One thing that really impressed me was that they own their own building. And not just that they own their building, but they were making improvements. They had just put a new roof on this building, and they were in the process of getting all the walls painted on the inside. And this is a big building, that's a large project. And this group was already doing it when I came. So I started out volunteering in the kitchen. I was washing dishes during the monthly Sunday breakfast. And so each month I'd come down here and I'd find myself part of this team that was bringing these lovely hearty meals to everybody that came through the door. So after washing dishes for a while, I got my first major milestone through the hall, and that was that I became co-manager of the kitchen. But I have to admit, the first couple of years, you see, I was working. And so every September, they'd have the pear pie peeling party. And I had to work. And I didn't like that much. But there were other ways that I was able to volunteer. We revamped the breakfast menu. We started buying more local foods and making more items in-house. We increased the quality of our meals and reduced the waste going out of here. And then at about that point, I went into semi-retirement, and then my volunteer work was even more important to me in my life. And then the last few years, I've actually been able to participate in the pear pie peeling parties. So recently, we've been hearing some talk about having the hall host some farm-to-fork dinners.
Oh, did I get a
book? Oh, sorry. Okay, now you go. Wrong one.
So, now I'm still my Go ahead and try it.
Hello?
Yeah.
Yes. So recently there's been some talk around about hosting farm to fork dinners here at the hall. That would be using local in-season food, just gathering from our community around, making it into meals and getting it out on the tables. So we have the building to do this. We've got the equipment, the capital. We have all the permits. We have desire and we have expertise. And we have a reputation here at the hall for bringing people good food and for having fun events. So what we're needing now is to find a few people who are willing to join our team, and then we will be able to make the local farm to fork dinners a reality here at Big Valley. So far as a wish list, we're volunteers. Okay, this is what we need. We need people with building experience, people with landscaping skills. We need mowers and whackers and people with vision. We need organizers and mobilizers. We need itemizers and philosophizers. But mostly right now, we need pear pie peelers. We need pear peelers and lots of pear peelers. So join us Friday, September 29th. That's the day before the Pear Festival. We start at 7 a.m. Come when you can. Bring your peelers, bring your friends. If you don't have a friend, one will be provided for you when you get here. Coffee, sweets, lunch will also be provided. The work generally slows down about noon when all the pears are peeled, but the chores will continue through the afternoon to accommodate any latecomers. So, if you're interested in volunteering or joining our hall, please talk to one of our members. Take home a brochure, one of those golden brochures from your table. Like us on Facebook. Big Valley Hall, thank you all for coming today.